After years of waiting, the Indonesian Air Force will receive new aircraft into their airlift fleet. Tomorrow, they are expecting the first of five of the latest C-130J-30 Super Hercules to arrive at Halim Perdana Kusuma Air Force Base in Jakarta. The C-130 itself has been part of the Indonesian Air Force and Indonesia in general for decades, and with this new addition, will continue the legacy for years to come. So, in today's video, let's take a look at what Super Hercules has to offer and its importance for Indonesia. The need for a new heavy airlifter for the Indonesian Air Force can be traced back as far as 2016. At that time, the candidates were the C-130J from Lockheed Martin and Airbus A400M. Then, according to several articles back in 2017, the previous defense minister chose the A400M over the C-130J. However, this decision never materialized. After a while, we didn't hear any news about this procurement, plus the pandemic that occurred in 2020, the program was started again in March 2021. But this time, the choice wasn't the A400M, rather the C-130J through direct commercial sales with Lockheed Martin. This procurement was later confirmed with the head of the Indonesian Air Force visit to Lockheed Martin facility in September that year. I couldn't find the contract value of this purchase, but the price tag of one C-130J in 2022 was around $75.5 million each. So my estimate for the Indonesian Air Force purchase is around $380 million. Then, on 21 February 2023, Lockheed Martin officially delivered the first C-130J-30 Super Hercules to the Indonesian Air Force. This aircraft has the tail number A1339 and will strengthen the 31 Air Squadron in Jakarta. The rest will be delivered gradually until 2024. But it wasn't over. The aircraft must take a long journey home first. On the 28th, one Lockheed Martin pilot, the 31 Air Squadron commander, and three other Indonesian Air Force officers make a ferry flight from Marietta, Georgia, where Lockheed Martin facility is located, to Monterey, California, Honolulu, Kwajalein Atoll, and Guam before landing in Jakarta. This flight will take 34 flight hours with a distance traveled approximately 18,300 km. This distance is equivalent to almost 4 round trips from Aceh to Merauke. If nothing gets in the way, tomorrow afternoon they will arrive in Jakarta. Developed as the successor of Legacy Hercules, the C-130J offers increased cargo capacity, speed, range, power, performance, and lower operating cost than its predecessor. From the outside, there's not a lot of difference with the Legacy models except for the number of blades on each propeller. There are 4 blades on each propeller for the Legacy model, while on the C-130J, there are 6. This is paired with 4 more powerful turboprop engines, Rolls-Royce AE2100D3, giving the Juliet model the ability to climb faster and higher, fly farther at a higher cruising speed, and take off and land in shorter distances. On the inside, the differences are more clear. The C-130J major system upgrades include a state-of-the-art dual pilot flight station with fully integrated digital avionics, color multifunctional liquid crystal or CMLC, heads-up display, as well as advanced navigation, including dual inertial navigation system and GPS. The aircraft is also equipped with a fully integrated self-defense system, low-power color radar, digital moving map display, and digital autopilot system. If the Legacy models can only carry 6 pallets, 92 combat troops, or 64 paratroopers, the Juliet model can carry up to 8 pallets, 128 combat troops, or 92 paratroopers. It also requires less crew. If the older ones require a minimum crew of 5, 2 pilots, navigator, engineer, and loadmaster, the C-130J only needs 3, 2 pilots, and a loadmaster. Performance-wise, the C-130J is more superior than the Legacy model. Even though they have the same dimension, except for the Dash-30 model that the Indonesian Air Force pick, it has a higher top speed, higher service ceiling, can carry more load, and can travel farther. So it's not wrong if it is named Super Hercules. As an archipelagic nation with vast territory and sitting in the ring of fire, Indonesia needs a mode of transport that can reach every corner of the nation to conduct whatever mission whenever we need it in a timely manner. And since a long time ago, aircraft, more specifically cargo aircraft, has been identified as the best method. It can fly from one island to another with ease, facilitating the movement of people and logistics. It's way quicker than land or sea-based mode of transport, which can be crucial in times of crisis such as natural disasters. And relatively, it costs less to build an infrastructure to operate an aircraft than the other mode of transport. Since the early 60s, the Indonesian Air Force have trusted their airlift capability to the C-130. And from the beginning, it's involved in every kind of mission involving the armed forces. From the preparation for the Trikora operation, Seroja operation, every HIDR mission, SAR operations, and even used to carry Hajj pilgrims to Mecca and carrying passengers across Indonesian cities. My mom had a chance to fly with it once in the 80s. It cost a lot less than a commercial flight. My point is, the C-130 has not only become a workhorse of the Indonesian Air Force, but also become an air bridge of Indonesia as a whole. Therefore, I'm very concerned about the condition of our C-130 fleet in the early 2000s due to the US embargo. We couldn't repair our C-130 fleet, some must be grounded, and some must be cannibalized to keep the other airworthy. Even that wasn't enough to prevent fatal accidents with the airframes declared total loss. Thankfully, the embargo was lifted some years later, and the Air Force C-130 fleet can fly without worries once more. Not only that, with the certification given to GMF Aero Asia to do MRO services of all older models of Indonesian C-130, we can be at ease. And tomorrow, a new era of Indonesia's air bridge capability will begin with a new and more powerful C-130J-30 Super Hercules, serving not only the military, but also 270 million Indonesian from Sabang to Merauke. I have big expectation of our Juliet, but I'm not worried, because I believe it will overcome it. Indonesia hasn't bought a new C-130 since the 80s when we bought a bunch of C-130H, so the timing of this procurement couldn't be better. Especially after the farewell ceremonies of the older C-130 we saw some time ago. And don't worry, the gray livery of our Super Hercules will stay like that. It will not be changed to green-brown camo like the older C-130 fleet. It's more fitting for a 21st century air force in my opinion. And that's it for today, new airlifter of the Indonesian Air Force, the C-130J. What do you think about this aircraft? Share with us in the comment section below. Thank you for watching everyone, I'll see you in the next one.